Good morning. Hey, it's Karen. Is anybody awake yet? I'm just going to wait a little bit of time to see if anybody's awake this time of day. It's pretty late, I guess. I'm not sure what time it is. Well, it's 9:22 on the West Coast, so. Anyway, I'll just wait a little bit and see if anybody's around. I've got one viewer who's there. Couple people on. I was just going to go through my morning makeup routine and talk to everybody and see what's going on. So, who's out there? Say hi. Let me know you're out there. Oh, great. Down to one. One little viewer. Who's that? I see one little thumbs up. Well, I am just going to go ahead and go get started on my little routine here. Those of you that don't know, I am a beauty guide with Limelight by Alcone, and we have a fabulous, fabulous skincare line and professional cosmetics line that is really great. Sorry about that. I was getting a phone call. Anyway, so I'm just going to go through my morning ritual. Who's there? Jan! Good morning, Jan. I'm so happy to see you. I didn't get to see you at work that whole week when I was there. So anyway, so I'm going to go through my skincare. So I start with a clean face. I used skincare last night and washed my face and everything, put on my moisturizer. So in the morning, some people like to use the cleanser again, but I go to bed clean, so I just wake up and kind of splash my face with water, and then I start with my skincare again. And this is Sotox. And this is, it's got Sanji mushroom extract in it and a very rare sea algae in it. And it helps to go into the skin. It's a booster. It goes into the cells of the skin to help start to heal them and repair any damage, aging cells. And it helps to replenish them a little bit faster. It also helps in tightening and brightening. So if you've got some dark spots, some sunspots, with continued use, you will see that will improve. So just one pump of that, and I just like tap it between my fingertips here and just lightly tap it around my face and let that kind of soak in. And Jan, if you're still there, anybody that's there, you can ask me questions, and then I want people to interact and give me suggestions for how you want me to do my eyes today, what colors I should use. So okay, so that feels really nice. It's not heavy in the least. Now the next product that I use is our little gem. This is One Drop Wonder. It's one single ingredient. It is Palmifera oil. It is cold pressed oil from the hedge apples. And the chemistry of this is super exciting. And I just do like one drop here in between my fingers, around my eyes. This is also a booster. The molecular structure of a booster will actually penetrate the skin cell itself below the surface of the skin. So this actually goes in and it helps to take other really good clean moisture and all the good benefits of other products down there with it. So this is antibacterial, it is antioxidant, and it's antifungal. So people are finding that if they have acne or cystic acne, hormonal acne, that it's actually going in and helping those things get healed up before they reach the surface of the skin, and they're seeing such a decrease in those things. They're also seeing a decrease in scars. There's a gal that posted a picture with a 10-year-old scar that she had on her cheek, and it was still red after 10 years, and it was a deep indentation, like a scoop out of her cheek. And she took a picture of it and put them side by side and unretouched, just side by side. And there is noticeable improvement. And that is an old scar. I've seen a new scar that looked like a hatchet job. A gal had an incision on her neck from some neck surgery. They went in the front of her neck. And it looked like she'd been cut open with a box cutter. And seriously, after 4 months of using One Drop Wonder and Sotox on that scar, once they said that she could apply any kind of topical agents to it, any ointments or anything, she just used One Drop Wonder and Sotox, and in 4 months it's almost completely gone. I mean, it is a hairline compared to what it was, and I do have pictures of that. Okay, so those are my two boosters I put on first. The next one I use is Skin Therapist. Hey Manny, if you're out there watching, I was just talking about the One Drop Wonder and Sotox and the results of healing scars on the skin. Hey baby, how are you? I need to send you this photograph because she had like 10-year-old scars on her, a 10-year-old scar on her face that was absolutely amazing. And so those two products might really help you. Now this is Skin Therapist. This is our great, you know, all over moisturizer. This is great for normal skin, dry skin. And I'm just kind of patting that in. It sounds like I'm using a lot of products, but I'm just using a little bit of each one. And they are all excellent on their own. So say you have a moisturizer that you absolutely love by some XYZ brand, that's fine. That's not going to diminish the fact that if you use One Drop Wonder and Sotox, it's not going to diminish their effectiveness. You can continue to use that if that's what you prefer. These are not, these products don't create a synergy saying that you have to use this and have to use that to get the full benefit of that product. These are all standalone products. So you will get all the benefits from Sotox if you use Sotox. You will get all the benefits of One Drop Wonder if you use just One Drop Wonder. Good morning, Kim. How are you, my wonderful friend? Nice to see you on there. Okay, so now I've got nice moisturizer on. And then the other product that sometimes I use, sometimes I don't, it's called Must Do, and it is a wonderful facial oil. And people think, ugh, I put oil on my skin, that's ridiculous. But your skin will love this. This is, I use it especially at night, but it actually works really well with our foundations, and it actually penetrates the skin. It's also a booster, so it's, again, going to help take that Sotox and the One Drop Wonder and the Skin Therapist into your skin cells where it's going to do the most good. And it gives you a really nice base for applying your foundation if you are so inclined to use foundation. And I just barely one pump of this. I don't know, you can't even see the amount of oil. Just a tiny bit. Again, I just tap it between my fingers. Oh my goodness, Mary Kate Duffy Kemper is on. Oh my gosh, I don't know what I'm gonna do with myself. I love you, Mary Kay. Okay, so I have four products on my face, and I know that sounds like a lot of products on my face, but my gosh, guys, can you see? Look at my skin. My skin is fabulous. And I'm going to tell you, I am 54 years old. 54, come on. You could have fabulous skin at 54. Oops, hang on, close. 54 years old. So come on, let's take care of ourselves. Let's look fabulous. You know, it doesn't. The age is a number. We can be fabulous at 54, and 55, and 65, and 75. So let's take care of ourselves. Okay. So that's my morning skincare routine, and super simple, right? One pump, one drop. Here and there, and there it goes. Oh my gosh, Laverne, how are you, my sweetheart? I can't believe you're on. Where are you? Are you in South Africa or Venezuela or somewhere else in between? Oh my gosh, Laverne's on. I am like over the moon excited. Oh, you are so fabulous yourself. I love you so much. Laverne, oh, you gotta see. Hang on. Can you see what I've got on? I've got Oasis of the Seas on. I'm getting in cruise mode. You're in South Africa. Oh, how's the baby? She's not a baby anymore. She's so beautiful. Laverne and I met when she was working. Oh, good morning, Betty. She was working as a ship's photographer on Mariner of the Seas when we took our cruise to the Mexican Riviera, and we are cruise fanatics. Good morning, Karen. And I see my friend, Miss Betty. I'm, like I said, I'm getting into cruise mode. Betty and her husband, Abe, and 3 years old now. Oh my gosh, that's incredible. So Betty and Abe and my husband and I are cruising the Pacific coast. And we sail in, we'll be on a ship in 1 month. We sail on the 30th of September, so we're getting really excited about that. And we collect cruise friends. We love to gather with other people that enjoy cruising. So anyway, it started out just Betty and Abe had booked it. They said, hey, book this. So we booked it because we cruise like that. And so I just spread the word with my other cruise friends. And now we're a party of 10. Isn't that incredible? I mean, it is so fun and cruising is so relational. It's just a blast. So if you haven't cruised, you need to cruise and cruise often because it is so fun. Sorry. I'm going to have to call back. Anyway, I'm going to get on with applying my makeup here this morning. So I'm going to be using our botanical foundations, and this is in Gina Beige. This is my color. This is what my current one looks like, and I'm going to need to get a spatula out and scoop some of that out and use it up. But just for today's purposes, I'm using our big fluffy brush number 2, and rumor has it that Kendra Aris, our wonderful, wonderful leader and ambassador with Limelight, she came up with this, I believe. If I'm wrong, somebody correct me. But anyway, super, super simple way to apply our botanical foundations. I'm going to take this, I'm going to swirl it a couple times in here and swirl it on my face. Really? Can it be any simpler than this? Make sure and get around your nose. I hate it when I miss the coverage around my nose because it's like I have like larger pores around my nose, although they are getting a little bit smaller and smoother. And I hate that look. I always say get your ears too because they're kind of connected to your face and you want that seamless, flawless look. And if you don't get your ears, then they're going to kind of stick out. Okay, so really that's about it. Okay, now I'm going to go back into my palette here. This top one's empty. You can get this little kit with two concealers and one of your foundations, and it's at a discounted rate, so that's really nice. But I just put my finger in here. Actually, I use my ring finger because, and I've got a mirror down here, so try to stay in the camera here. And I'm just going to smooth that under my eye and kind of come down a little bit on my cheekbone. Use any residual on your eyelid because that'll work as a really great base for your eyeshadows, okay? So I have a little redness here in the corner from my glasses, and I'm hoping that my new glasses are ready soon. I know Laverne, I cannot believe that she is 3 years old now. That is not even funny. Oh, no, it is a cream foundation. It is, it's made with plant wax and plant oil. So it's cosmetic plant oil and wax and 50% pigment. So just to give you an idea, if you go to any beauty counter in a department store, you're probably only going to get somewhere in the range of maybe 15 to 25% pigment. Our foundations have 50% pigment. What that translates to you is you can use so much less. Sorry about that. You didn't hear that. You can use so much less of the product to get the coverage that you want. And ours is buildable coverage. So if you want a little bit more coverage, you have a little area that maybe is extra red for some reason, you can go back in and just touch up that little area and it's going to build on that. But you're not going to get that cakey look. You're going to get like a second skin look. It is so weightless. It's unbelievable. In fact, when I first started using it, I'm thinking this doesn't feel right. It just doesn't feel like I have enough on my face. But after a week or so, it's like, oh no, this is awesome because it does feel weightless. It doesn't feel like you have anything on your skin. And you get this flawless, beautiful coverage because of the pigmentation in our product. So anyway, hi, Kathy. You have a great day too. I hope you're still on. We need to get together and have a nice tea or something. I'm home for a little bit. And then after I go back to work for a week, then I come back and I'm off for a month. So I can't believe it. It's weird how my schedule worked out. But we're going to be cruising so at the end of that month. So, and I think I'm going to be having an open house, Limelight open house for a couple of days. somewhere around the 24th and 25th, I think, of September. So probably going to do like the Friday evening, like a 7 to 9 or 7 to 10, and then Saturday from like 11 to 2 or something, where people can just pop in and pop out, learn a little bit about skincare. We can do little quickie makeovers and things like that. So it'll be fun. I'm probably going to do like margaritas and makeup and sangria and skincare or something like that. So, oh, absolutely. I can work that out for you, Laverne. Yes, my dear, we can work that out. We will message each other and get you hooked up. Okay, so that's my foundation. So pretty good. All right. Next, I am going to be using some bronzer, which I have never in my life been a bronzer girl until I got perfect bronzer. I mean, when it's perfect, you have to use it, right? So, okay, perfect bronzer. Perfect bronzer is such a nice shade, and it has a very small amount of shimmer. So when you use it, you don't look like a bronze statue. And that's what I always hated, when I'd see these girls with this bronzer all over their face, and I thought, oh, that looks so unnatural. And to me, it was unattractive. And if you use bronzer like that, I'm sorry if I insulted you, but I think you'll really, really like ours better. Now, this is a trio. I love, love, love Limelight's packaging and options. You can order individual products. You can get a single that'll, you know, come in one little palette like this. In the singles, you can pop them out. You got a little pan there. Pop out here. They're magnetic and they're cardboard, so they're, you know, really highly biodegradable. You know, they break down, really good for the environment. Anyway, so you can get them in singles. You can get them in duos. And you can get them in trios. And because these are the three products that I use the most, like every single day, I get them in a trio, and it saves me a little bit of money. And then I have everything at my fingertips when I'm doing my makeup, which is time saving, and we like things that save us time and money. And these guys are super, you have more, I'm losing my words here, interchangeable. So not only are these great blushes and bronzers, they can be used as eyeshadows as well. Or you want to add some sparkle to your lips, you can add a little bit of this blush number 6. So really interchangeable. They're dual duty products or multiple duty products, and those are really nice things to have. Let's see. Oh, Kim, remind me what idea I gave you, because I don't. Oh yeah, I use the same blush. Guys, I've had that blush since November. Can you see that? You can't tell that I've had it since November, and I use it every single day. There's barely an indentation. That's how highly pigmented these products are. So don't be afraid, and their price point is so awesome too. Okay, so my bronzer, I'm using my my angled blush brush. So I've dipped it into my bronzer, and I've got a mirror down here, so I'm gonna try and stay in frame.
Okay.
Honey, I'm on live right now, so I'm gonna come right here into kind of the hollow of my cheek and then work it around my hairline. And my 2-day party. Oh, yeah, it's going to be a great little, you know, easy peasy. Limelight isn't hard. Limelight is just coming around, gathering a few people together and sharing and showing some tips and tricks. Don't forget to get underneath here. This is kind of like an easy, I call it my lazy girl contouring, okay? This is something so simple. Okay, so it just, I'm very, very ghostly white. And I use Gina Beige. It's the best match for my skin, but I still look like a ghost, and I don't like to go out in the sun and get color, because really the sun's not that great for you, and it's not that great for your skin. But I want to look like I have a little healthy glow, and so my products will do that for me. So I did my bronzer. Now I'm just going to get one little swipe of blush, okay? And right on the apple of your cheek. Okay, it looks brighter in the camera than it does in person. Okay. And just blend it. These brushes do all the work for you. These are professional grade brushes. They're made specially for us because we are special, you know. And they were handpicked, and they came to fruition because of a great gal, well, our CEO, who's a great gal, and another great gal, Kat Aragon, who's a professional makeup artist, and she helped design and bring these brushes to fruition. And the beautiful thing about these is they are all 100% synthetic. They are vegan, and you don't get any fallout, so you're not going to do your makeup and have brush hairs on your face. And because they're synthetic, you can clean them with our Come Clean cleanser, our brush cleaner and shampoo, and they're perfectly good to use in any product. So I can use it in a powder product, and then I can use it in a cream product and back into a powder product. So it makes it, when they clean up completely, and you can't go back and forth if you're using a natural hair bristle brush. So that's really an important aspect of our brushes, and they're super wonderful. That's all I can say. Anyway, Delana, hi. Oh, thank you. How you discuss the process. Good job. Oh, thank you. You know, I love what I do. And if I can help anybody feel better about themselves and have more confidence, that my job's done. You know, I just happen to love doing that, and having the best products on the planet to do that with makes all the difference in the world. Okay, so I've done bronzer and blusher, and now I'm going to just use this, and I just have a towel down here that I'm, you know, brushing my brush off in between. And I'm going to pick up, this is blush number 6, and I think it's called Glowing. We used to call it the Illuminator, and so I still like saying the Illuminator because we want to illuminate our faces. We don't necessarily need them to be flat, matte. We want them to have contour and life and color and just glowing. We want to be glowing, right? So I tell people to use the Illuminator where the sun might kiss your face first, which is going to be down your nose, on the forehead here, above the brows. Oops, almost went back into the blush. On the cheeks here. Now, if you have a lot of laugh lines, if you smile a ton with your eyes and you have those laugh lines, you might want to skip it right here. Because if you put something that has a little bit of shimmer and is shiny, it might draw more attention to those than you want. So you might want to stay away from the laugh line, which, don't stop laughing. We want you to laugh and smile, so don't stop that. Just don't use the Illuminator right there. But you can put it on the other areas. So it gives more dimension to your face, because something that's lighter is going to bring it out forward. So down your nose, on the tip of your chin, above your brows. There you go. Okay, so that was my bronzer trio, my blush and bronzer trio. Okay. Now, let's see. You want to see my lazy girl brows, or you want to see my other brows? You have to vote if anybody's still there. I have a couple people that are still on. Lazy brows or regular brows? Nobody's talking. Susan, good morning. Nice to see you. Anybody? Anybody? Nobody's talking to me anymore. You're going to make me feel lonesome that I'm talking to myself. Okay. Well, oh, lazy girl, Kim. Oh, Karen, lazy girl. All right. You got lazy girl. All right. I am going to go for the lazy girl this morning. This is my next lazy girl pencil. I'm a lazy girl too. Good morning, Miss Jessica. How is the bean this morning? Jess has got the sweetest little baby girl. Anyway, so of course it ran out. This is a NYX micro brow pencil, and I always have a spare because I'm a lazy girl. Lazy girl's got to be prepared. Just because we're lazy doesn't mean we aren't prepared. That's my motto. I'm a Boy Scout. Be prepared. That's why my carry-on bag always weighs 37 and a half pounds. No. Okay, so super fine point on one side and spoolie brush on the other side. So as you can see, my eyebrows look like they looked in 1974 when I was in junior high school, because we all plucked our brows to the nth degree, and so now they don't grow back. Yeah, Kim, I'm all about quick and easy too. Yes, you have to bring the bean over. I'm home for a little bit, so hopefully I've got one shift that I have to drop for Monday, and nobody's picking it up, which is a little troubling to me. I don't want to have to fly back to Phoenix and work 4 hours, so hopefully. Okay, so quick eyebrow tutorial. My quick eyebrow fix. Oh, hoping Lynette will come out with one for us. Oh yeah, I hope so too. Because Lottie even said, Lottie, this amazing makeup artist, was at our conference, and she said that she even does them with pencil, which is cool. But my non-lazy girl is using our 10 years younger spray, and our brow tamer brush. It's got a stiffer angle brush there and a spoolie. And basically you're gonna just spritz some 10 years younger solution liquid into a little dish or wherever you want to put it, and dip your brush into that. You don't want to saturate it, and then dip it into our eyeshadows, and then you just gonna do the same thing pretty much as what I'm gonna do with the pencil. Anyway, so I've got my little pencil here. So you want your brows to start, this is a good guideline. Line it up on the edge of your nose and straight up. This is about where you want your brow to start. If you need a visual, then just rub it a little bit so you kind of get a dot. You can see I'm like missing a lot of brows. Second mark is going to be where your arch should be. Again, line it up on the edge of your nose, cross your... Okay, sorry, I lost you for a second. Okay, so edge of your nose, across the pupil when you're looking straight ahead, and that's gonna be your second mark. And I've done this for a long time, so I don't have to really mark them anymore. I kind of just go with it. And the third mark is going to be the outer corner of your eye up against your nose, the outer edge of your nose. And you don't want to go past that last mark. Okay? So now you got three marks. Good morning, Laura. Nice to see you this morning. This is awesome. This is really only a couple of... Cindy Drews, you're up this morning. Hopefully operations was good last night and you didn't have to stay really late, or maybe you were off. Okay, so now that I've got my marks here, I was just showing people how I mark where to put my eyebrows, and I've just put one little mark here right along the vertical outside edge of my nose, across your pupil on the outside of your nose, and across the corner, the outer corner of your eye to make your outside line. Okay, so now I'm just going to use short strokes and kind of play connect the dots here. And I don't know why I did the top first. I don't know why it is I always seem to do the bottom of my brow first, because that's where I'm missing so many lashes, and so I kind of build up that area first. Short strokes, you don't want it to look like you've used a crayon. And I'm just going to continue to fill in short strokes here. Good morning, Annette. How are you? This is so much fun. It's like we get together and have a little chat this morning. I'm loving this. I've always been kind of nervous about doing a live, but this is really the coolest when people that you don't get a chance to visit with pop on and you're so surprised. It's like, oh, this is awesome. Okay, so this is kind of, hey, it looks pretty good in there. A little closer, I'm like, don't stand too close to me. You might see all the boo-boos. Okay. Hey, Laura, are you off today or are you flying somewhere? I just have to say, I love Facebook. I love how it brings us all together in one place, but we can be so many different places. And my network is getting so big, and I have friends from all over the world, and it's just so cool to see that. I've got friends that I went to kindergarten with many, many moons ago. You just got in? Oh, I bet you're beat. Yeah, I got home Monday afternoon. So yeah, I'm starting to feel semi-human. After I go to work, I'm kind of dead for a day or two. So, but the hubby's got a day off, so we're gonna go do some stuff together. Do the obligatory Costco run. Let's see. I love Facebook too. Oh, yes, it does. It keeps us connected. It's not just a game. It's serious. You know, it's a relational thing. You know, it really truly keeps us together. And it doesn't matter where we are, we can stay connected. Okay. So, there you have my lazy girl brow. And always remember that your brows are sisters. They are not identical twins. So, good tip. Don't fret about them being exactly perfect. And, so I can just brush them out a little bit so that if I have any heavier strokes than that, they won't stand out so much. You're doing your brows too. Sandra. Wait, who's Sandra? Hi, Sandra. Do you know my friend Karen? I don't see a Sandra on here. Yes, sisters. Kim is my new best friend that we've known for 20 years. Well, no. How do I want to say that? She's my 20-year-old friend that I just met. How about that? I don't know. I got to figure out how to say it right. We just met, but we clicked it off so fast. It was like we were fast friends, and it felt like we've known each other forever and ever. And then I got to meet Karen and her husband. I think I impressed Tony by knowing that he was Finnish. And that I knew how to say your last name right. Anyway, this is way fun, guys. Now I can see why everybody does these lives. It's just like fun times. Okay, on to eyeshadows. So, tomorrow, good morning. How are you? Or it's almost, what time is it? Oh, no, it's still morning. Yes, he was impressed. Yeah. I play a game at work, and I try to guess where people are from. So it's just right up my alley to know that he was Finnish. So anyway, those double vowels give you away. Anyway, so I have to show you. These are like my babies here. I used to only... Good, I'm glad you're doing good tomorrow. I love these brushes, guys. I've always been a makeup junkie. I used to get in trouble because when I was little, I mean really little, probably first or second grade, my sister was like 3 years older than me, I would get into her makeup and I'd be sent to go take a bath. I'd go into the bathroom and I'd put makeup all over my face and I'd look at myself in the mirror and then... Yes, I have considered microblading for my brows. I'm just not there yet, but I am seeing some amazing looking brows with the microblading. Serious amazing looking brows, but it's kind of like on the back burner in my head, Vernay, so maybe, I don't know. I know people say it doesn't hurt much, but okay, I'm a chicken. I'm a chicken to get my eyes brows microbladed. I don't know if it pauses when things pop up on your phone or not. Anyway, so I would put my makeup on and then get in the tub and wash it off, and nobody was the wiser. So I've always played with makeup, but I never used any tools, real tools, or good tools. Like, are you laughing at my putting on my makeup and then getting in the tub, Laverne? Laura, good morning. So anyway, I've always just used, you know, drugstore makeup. I think one time 100 years ago, I did spend like $50 for a foundation from a drugstore, or not a drugstore, from a department store. And I just used it once, you know, that one bottle. And then it was like, I can't spend that kind of money on foundation. And I spent like $50 back, and I'm talking, that was probably 30 years ago or more. So it was really expensive foundation, and it doesn't do what my foundation can do now. And the price point on ours is just absolutely phenomenal. Anyway, so back to the packaging. I would just use whatever sponge brush or whatever came in the package of the drugstore makeup, because that's all I used since then. So these babies are like my children. I was like, oh, if I had to be in Sophie's Choice, which that was a horrible movie, I couldn't stand it. But if I only could choose one, I wouldn't know which ones to choose, because they are so wonderful. Like I said before, they're all vegan, all synthetic, super, super smooth. They will blend your eyeshadows just impeccably. So anyway, I will get going. Does anybody have any suggestions? Shall I do grays? Shall I do browns? I'll show you the color palette. This is our 18 well palette of eyeshadows. These are the feeling is mutual. No, I always say that. It's not. It's the feeling is neutral. Neutral. So these are our neutral colors. And they are so super smooth, and they blend so well. Oh, I love you, Karen. That's my favorite. I love the grays too. Oh, we have great minds on here. Everybody's telling me gray, so gray it shall be. Okay, so when we were at convention, we had Lottie Stannard, the world famous, amazing professional makeup artist. Okay, fine, gray. Okay, Laverne. Anyway, so Lottie is going to be coming out with a new collection. She's going to bring some bright, bold colors, and she's going to have two palettes. One is going to be more on the neutral side, and one is bright, bold colors. And then she's got three new colors of Enduring Lip Color. And just to give you a hint, she is professional makeup artist for Halsey, the singer, the amazing singer. And she named all of her colors after certain people or her pets or songs that have been made famous by The Cure. And the one Enduring Lip Color that I cannot wait to get my hands on is Halsey. So anyway, so that's just a little sidebar. But anyway, so I'm gonna show a couple of tips that she showed. And I'm really liking it. I've been putting her techniques into play when I've been doing my makeup, and really liking it. So what she does first is she takes one color, a light color, and I'm gonna take this light pink. And if anybody is on there that knows, I think this is Pastel Me something or other. All of our colors are numbered, and then they have a pun attached to them, which they are super cute, but I've only learned a couple of them. So I'm just going to smooth this all over my eye. So it's going to be like my base. And once you have this base on there, the rest of the colors are going to blend super smoothly over the top. Now, mind you, when I get ready in the morning, it takes me about 20 minutes start to finish to do my makeup. So it's just because I'm jabbering here with you guys. So. Laverne, I'll do brown for you another day, okay? Okay, so that was our large shadow brush. It's kind of on the flat side. I don't know if you can tell, but it's flat. Let's see if it'll pick it up. But it's narrow, okay? So it's wide but narrow. So lots of uses. And that's what, you know, they have named these brushes certain things, but it's not exclusive. Like, you can do whatever you want to do with them. It's just people are discovering other things. Just like that foundation brush that I used, that was designed to be an all-over powder brush. But guess what? It works fantastic to apply our foundation. So this is one of my very, very favorite brushes. And this one is our pointed blender, and it's tapered, as you can see, right on the sides here at the tip. And so it's got a kind of a, well, no, you can't see that from, but it has got a smaller tip, and then halfway down it is tapered. So all of those little individual fibers will work to blend. I'm trying to read this. Oh, I'm sorry you lost connection, Tomorrow. Let's see. Does it matter about what color your eyes are? Yeah, it does. I always say there's no rule in applying. There are no rules in makeup. There are things that work better than others. But whatever makes you feel the most comfortable is what you should use. So, you can kind of go on the color wheel and see what the complementary colors are for your eyes. I know brown eyes generally can wear greens and purples really well, sometimes browns. And I know a lot of people love the neutral colors and the browns. I am not one of them. I'm kind of out of my comfort zone a little bit, and it's only because when I was in high school, our school colors were brown and gold, and I was a cheerleader, and so I have had enough brown in my life to last a lifetime. Seriously, I know that sounds ridiculous, but I like color. I don't like earth tones so much in decorating, or even, you know, I've always had bold colors. I really preferred bold colors, but I am a cool toned skin person. So, and if you've ever had your colors done, I'm a winter. So, I can wear purples and those rich jewel tone colors I can wear really easily. So my neutral that I like to wear would be a gray. I can sometimes get away with wearing blues. Certain blues look good on me as long as they're on the cool side. But anyway, people that have green eyes and blue eyes wear the neutral colors so well. You wouldn't put blue on a blue eye, but you could put purple on a green eye. That looks fabulous. Or you could put copper on a green eye, and that's gorgeous too. So anyway, and it also depends on the shape of your eye, you know, how the colors look too. And it's all how you wear them, and it's how you feel when you wear them. If you feel tired and you look in the mirror and think, oh, I look tired, then maybe that's not the best color for you. Or you look in the mirror and it's like, you like how you look, then wear that. That's what's important. Okay, so I've got my base color on. So I'm gonna go in this little gray. It's kind of a bluish, a cool gray, and it's a matte, and it's called High Quality, like koala, like the little cute animal. Like I said, all kind of puns on here. So I'm just gonna get a tiny bit. I mean, super highly pigmented, right? So I'm gonna start here in the outer corner of my eye and kind of above the crease. I have hooded eyes. See where my crease is down here. But really where my eye socket is like another quarter inch up here. So I wanna bring it up higher and kind of work it back and forth. Oh my gosh, Kendra is on. I am nervous now. Woo! So I'm just gonna put some high quality in here because we are high quality limelight. Okay, so the other thing too with ours, always a little tiny bit, and then you can go back and add in more if you want a little bit more color, because I'm telling you, these are so highly pigmented. Little bit goes a long way. So, back and forth. And it also depends on the pressure that you use. These brushes will do a lot of the work for you. Just find the right pressure, and you can always go back and build if you need to add a little bit more color. Now, some people like to apply it all and then go back and blend it all. Now, I kind of blend a little as I go so that I kind of get the color intensity that I want where I want it. Okay, so I'm gonna go into the next one, which is probably one of my very favorite colors. And this one is called Ready Jet Set Go, and it is a beautiful charcoal-y gray with a tiny bit of shimmer in it. And I use this one a lot for my eyeliner too. So again, a little bit on my tip, and I'm gonna come out here just a little above my crease, kind of like on the brow bone. I'm gonna do little circles and smooth those in. Little circles. And then I'll bring it down here to the corner of my eye. Now, a lot of people have, a lot of makeup artists have preferences as to putting your foundation on first and then doing eyes, or eyes first and then foundation. And there are pros and cons to both. I've always been a do my foundation first girl. And the reason is that if I don't do that first and I have that base, doing my eyes, I feel like my eyes look flat because the rest of my face isn't done first. A lot of professional makeup artists do it the other way, because they say if they have any fallout from the shadows, that it's really easy to just wipe that off and not have to take off any of the foundation in the process of, and then having to retouch the foundation. So it's really a personal preference. Whatever makes you feel most comfortable, let that work for you, okay? So I just wanna, because I have like a pretty big eye area here, I like to bring it up a little bit higher. Loving the eyeshadow. Laverne, I love you. Yes, I am 54 and almost 54 and a half. I'll be 55 in April. Yeah, Kim, when I was little, I would always, or little, when I was a teenager, I would always, you know, get the 17 magazine and all of that. And I loved all the makeup tutorials on there. So I would pick up little tips and tricks. And my mom always wore makeup, and my sister. So I would learn from them as well. So like I said, I've always been a makeup fan, always, you know, enjoyed the glam and that kind of stuff. And, you know, you just pick up little nuggets, you know, you don't have to learn it all overnight. Just, you know, try one new technique, see if you can do that one technique and then build from there. Or try a bunch at one time and see what works. You know, it's all about what makes you feel the best that you can be, okay? Can you believe that it is August 31st? What is up with that? Seriously, the year is like screeching toward the finish line here. But being a desert dweller, I am so relieved that cooler temperatures are on the horizon. Seriously, I am so over the heat. I am looking forward to sweaters and making soup and pumpkin things, pumpkin bread, come on. I had a pumpkin donut yesterday. I don't know if anybody saw my post. I seriously have been wanting a donut for 6 weeks. 6 weeks, and I just have not done it. And I saw a Dunkin' Donuts yesterday, and I thought, I'm going into Dunkin' Donuts and getting a donut. And they had a pumpkin donut. And I sat in there, and I was doing some work on my phone and messaging people, and I enjoyed my donut. I knew that I needed to get a donut, because I almost tackled a passenger that was boarding a flight that had a huge, big pink box from Voodoo Donuts. And anybody that knows Voodoo Donuts in Portland, Oregon, knows that those donuts are amazing. You should look them up. They're incredible. Okay, so now I've got some shadow on there. Now I'm going to pick another brush. I'm going to use, this guy is our Smoky Blender, and he's a little bit stiffer. Why do I call him he? I don't know. So a little bit stiffer brush, and these are good for doing a little bit smoky look. Okay, so just dipped it into the charcoal gray. And I'm not going to do a heavy line here today. I'm just going to do a little, like maybe to the center of my eye. And then on the top here. Okay. See, that gives a little bit more depth to my eyes. I feel like that side is a little bit brighter because my desk is in between two windows, and so I'm trying to balance out the light here. Oh, Laverne, that's so sweet. You studied beauty and I'm teaching you new stuff. Oh my gosh, that makes my heart sing, really. Don't forget the parka we have for cold weather. Yeah, in my airline life, we are getting new uniforms, and every single person had to order, get this, a parka. I think that thing weighs 12 pounds. The hooded parka, and it's got like fur on, I mean, it's not fur, but it's fake fur on the outside of it, and an all-weather jacket that is full length. It's like a trench coat, rain coat hooded, and it's got a full lining on it, so you can zip out the lining. I mean, these things, I work in Phoenix and I live in Las Vegas. I'm not planning a trip to Antarctica, although I'd like to go, but it's not on my horizon right now. So I don't know what I'm gonna do with these coats. They're gonna gather dust. Hey, Fran, good morning. Nice to see you this morning. Okay, so I'm just adding a little bit of depth of color here, right on the lash line. Okay. All right. I don't know if you can hear my music. This is Sam Hunt in the background. I love this song. Okay. So now I could just continue to blend, because I did have that pink on the lower there, but I just kind of need to kind of clean it up and I don't know. It's kind of hard to tell. I think I need a little bit more on this side. Over here, it looks uneven to me. Mm-hmm. Oh, I didn't realize that I was calling. I meant all of my brushes I've given a male gender too. I call them all he's, not just that guy. Oh! Good morning, Rhonda. How are you? How is life in Georgia? Oh my gosh, I am going to be doing lives all the time. I love being able to talk to you guys like this. Oh, I'm here. I'm still here. Yapping at the mouth. Betty, I'm glad you're back. Okay, so I'm going to come back here with my large brush, and I'm going to go with the next darkest pink, and sorry, don't know the name of that one, but we'll find out if you want to know. Maybe I can go back in afterwards and tell you what they are. I'll put it in the comments. Okay, so this is another Lottie tip, is to load your brush, tap it on here. So I got some product on there. Can you see it closer? Okay, now to get more of an opaque and more coverage, you're going to pat it on, just tap, instead of brushing it like I did the crease in the darker. You're gonna just tap it on there. So it's really kind of packing down. And can you see, I've definitely got more pink as opposed to what I brushed on, that lighter pink here. You can definitely see that's got a little bit more pink tone to it, because it's, I patted it on. Okay. So, now time for this little guy. See, I call them all guys. I don't know why. Why aren't they girls? Okay, this is our little dome blender. And this is so super smooth and soft. All those little fibers are gonna work together. And you go from the light into the dark. Light into the dark to blend. Light. Just to kind of smooth those transitions, so you're getting that. Now I want to go take this little guy and go into my inner corner here, just to brighten it up. You know, sometimes blood vessels are real close to the surface of the skin there, and this will help to brighten that area up. Some people even like to bring the bright and lightness underneath here, this inner corner of your eye, to brighten it up. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, I like it. Good morning, Donna. Nice to see you. I got to see you at work. Oops, I just lost my brush. Sorry. Okay. So I've got that. Now, time for eyeliner. I love eyeliner. I was never a big eyeliner person. What'd I do? I have to find my cat. I better find him now. I felt it. Uh-oh. Well, it's like losing a contact lens on carpet. I just lost the lid to my angled liner brush. I love this brush. This brush turns any eyeshadow into your eyeliner. So if you're doing copper eyes, you can use your copper eyeshadow and are 10 years younger. No way. No way. Oh my gosh. I am blown away who just joined. My beautiful, wonderful, amazing CEO of Limelight is on. Michelle, I cannot believe you joined my live this morning. I'm a little nervous now. Okay, so I have this little ceramic dish that is on my desk, and it was a gift from my husband's aunt, who I dearly love, and she dearly loves us. But anyway, it's a handmade gift from her. But I keep it on my desk, and I spritz one spritz of, this is actually 10 years younger, but it's in my travel bottle because I fly back and forth to work all the time. So 10 years younger. And this is magic fluid, okay, magic liquid. And I'm just going to use my little liner brush and dip it in the liquid. And I can choose any color on my palette to make eyeliner. So I usually just keep it to the bottom edge of my shadow so it doesn't change the consistency of the entire pan of shadow. So I'm going to come in here and just grab some of the oh, thanks, Michelle. Oh, Fran, yeah. Oh, no, I don't want Paxton to find, or, wow, Indigo. Wow, where'd Paxton come from? That was a blast from the past. Yeah, I don't want Indy to eat that cap because it protects the bristles on this brush. Anyway. Because I am 54 and I have, have to use a little bigger mirror here, I'm gonna come in, I'm just gonna lay this on my lash line and just gently drag it across. Now, I want all ladies to try this. Seriously, all ladies of any age can wear eyeliner. People say, oh, my eyes are too crepey, my eyes are this, my eyes are that. That's not true. You can do it. You just have to be a little bit more patient and keep working it back and forth. My eyes are crepey too. If you get in here and look close, the eyelids are crepey and they're starting to come down a little bit. But what I do is just take a little bit of product on my brush and I work it back and forth until I get that smooth line. So if you need more tutorials, we can get on FaceTime and we will do it together. I promise we will get you going on eyeliner. And I can't tell you enough how much I love this brush because that makes every eyeshadow eyeliner. So back and forth, right along the lash line. Am I covering up? I want you to be able to see this. Right in here, right into the inner corner. It's such a fine point. It's amazing. Now it's not super heavy. Can you see? I've got it really, really fine in the front or in the inner corner. You can do your wings with this. I love you too, Michelle. This is pretty exciting that you're on this morning. Well, it's this afternoon where you are, I'm sure. So I already did that smoky liner brush with the same color that I'm using for eyeliner, actually. So again, these are all buildable, and you will have a little bit more intensive color when you wet them. So, okay. Oh, Michelle, can you hear the song that's on? It's Tim McGraw, Humble and Kind. This song gives me goosebumps. Okay. So, I don't know if you can see. Can you see? I did my wing, but I start on the outside of my wing and work it in. And I don't know if it's just me or if younger gals do that too, but I, instead of going outward, I start where I want it to end and come in, and then I fill in. So, and this is such a beautiful color. It's not as harsh as black. It's just a nice, beautiful charcoal gray. Okay. You know what? We have one bar soap, and I don't know that it's got goat's milk in it. If Michelle's still on, if you could speak to that, I don't know. Thanks, Kara Lee. Oh, I know, Ginger. I remember the very first day I heard this song, and I got goosebumps. I mean, I just, when I heard that song, I knew immediately it was going to go to number one because it was so beautiful and the message was so amazing. And it's such, you know, it's something that our world needs. Can you imagine if everybody was humble and kind in this world? We wouldn't need any wars. We wouldn't need police officers. We wouldn't need a lot of things if everybody was just humble and kind. Okay, so keep going back and forth, picking up a little bit more color off my palette. Yes, Tim does sing real life songs. He has a message in his songs, that's for sure. And I'm a sucker for a song in three-quarter time. There's just such a, it's a beautiful sound to me. My ears perk up as soon as I hear that. It's just, you just want to dance to them. Am I getting close enough so you can see this? Okay, how's that looking? I'm liking it, but this is what I like all the time. This is like my everyday go-to, so. All right, so my eyeshadows are done. My eyeliner's done. Okay. So I'm gonna show you. I specifically left my hair undone so you guys could see this. This is one of the things that, I don't want to say it's a flaw, this is one of the my challenges that I'm dealt with. I have balding. Can you see this? I have like alopecia. So I don't have this gorgeous, luxurious head of hair like lots of people have. But anyway, and my eyelashes are the same. So, even though we have a wonderful, world-famous fiber mascara, I still wear falsies because my lashes are so short. But I'm going to show you our mascara because I'll use it on the bottom lashes. But you'll see how short they are. And the ones that I do have, they grow down like a camel. So it's really hard to get them to show up. So, but I know girls that have just average lashes have amazing results with our fiber mascara. Okay, I don't know if you can see. Super, super, super duper short. So, I'll just come in and do a little bit on my lower lashes. Trying to rush and I get it on my waterline here. Okay. So you can see that. So I'm just going to come over and do the waterline here. or the lower lashes. You know, I have tried Nioxin for my hair. I haven't had success with that. What did I miss? Met Tim in the ruins of Delphi on the occasion of Faith's 40th. Did you know that? Tim McGraw. You met Tim McGraw. Oh, no, I didn't know that, Betty. That's awesome. Actually, Fran, he was going into our bedroom. That's the door to our bedroom. He had a doctor's appointment this morning, and he was talking downstairs, and I was like, hey, I'm on live. Which I don't even think he knows what that is. Sorry, I felt like I was slipping out of my chair. All right. So, since I'm giving you my whole beauty routine, I'm gonna put my lashes on too. So, and I use my lashes several times, over and over. So I have my little bag of tricks. I have a little scissor style tweezer, and I grab my lash like this so that when it's ready to go on my eye, it just goes on my eye, okay? So I transfer it to my other hand. Now there's two ways of gluing it. I normally use this one. It's a dark tone duo. It comes out like a dark charcoal gray, almost black, which is nice because then it doesn't really show up. Some people recommend the clear. Oh, this other tube that I just went because they didn't have that, and I was getting a replacement because I'm a Boy Scout and always have to have a backup to be prepared. And they have this one that's in a tube, and I don't know if it doesn't like the plane rides back and forth, but now it's like leaking all over the place. And it's made by the same company, only it has a brush. And the jury's still out on it. It is a really dark one, and so I can just brush it on here. It's super, super sticky. So when, I'll just kind of tell you how I put the others on. I always would carry a piece of foil. I have like a little baggie that has my little tools in it. Piece of foil, and I squeeze out a little bit of the glue on the foil, and then I would dip a toothpick into it, and then just very thin coat of glue on that rim. And oh, just get a magnifying mirror. Just get something like this. It's I don't even know how many times it magnifies. You can do it, Ginger. It's not that hard. Even with you know, it's my close-up vision is getting worse. So I use the big magnifying. I have super great vision, actually. In answer to your question, Betty, do you need special makeup mascara remover? No. Actually, if I've got mascara on, it comes off with our regular quench cleanser. I don't even need to use anything else, but if you want a super simple way to, and especially with your travels, Betty, you might really want to get our makeup wipes. They are fabulous, and they're made of Italian cotton, and they have a very gentle solution, and they take off every bit of makeup off of your face. They're really great. I throw them in my suitcase. So on the nights that I don't want to use the cleanser, or if I just want to sit down and not stand for any more time, I just sit on the bed and take my makeup off. Let's see. I want to make sure I get everybody's questions here. Yeah, Ginger, just get a good magnifying, you know, and I just got this at, you know, Target or something like that. No need for special remover. Yeah. Our wipes, the wipe offs by Alcone, are amazing. So anyway, back to these lashes. So I've got them here. I'm going to just lightly brush the, I can't see. All right. So right along that little strip there. Like I said, this is super sticky glue, and it leaked out of the tube. So now I'm just gonna set them on the lash line. Okay, and I'm gonna grasp the edge with my tweezer and set it down. and grab the end of the lashes and set these guys down. Okay, once I get them set, you know, you want to get as close to the base of your natural lashes as possible. Now with this particular glue, let me back up with the other glue. I would take these tweezers and I would just kind of crimp it down all the way around. Now I saw another technique where the makeup artist actually had one of those old style hair clips, you know, just like the ones you pinch. And like if you were setting your hair, you would pinch it and it opens up, and he used that to crimp them. I think these lashes were Ardell. Is this made by Ardell? This is Duo glue. I don't know if it's made by Ardell or not, but the lashes that I have on are Ardell. I think these are 110s. But with the sticky glue, I'm just kind of using my finger, because what would happen is if I tried to crimp with my tweezers, the glue would actually stick to the tweezer and pull my lash off, which I wasn't too happy about. But these are just a real small, natural looking one. I don't know if you can see very well in here. But anyway, let me go on to number two real quick. And then I want to show you what I do in case anybody out there that's watching that I don't know about that needs help with their hair. I know that there's another company out there that's doing stuff with hair, and a friend of mine, actually the gal that was my roomie at the convention, she's using it, and she says that it's helping her hair fill in. She was losing hair, and it was helping her as well. I think, Vernie, that I'm not consistent with the Nioxin products because I don't wash my hair every day. In fact, I don't wash it very often. Maybe a couple of times a week is all. So, oh, let's be cooperative here, folks. Okay, you lay back down where you're supposed to. Okay, there we go. Thank you, Kim. Yeah, it makes me feel more confident. To me, they look fairly natural. They don't look, you know, I don't like the like super thick ones that it's like, oh yeah, you can tell a mile away she's wearing false eyelashes. I'd rather have a little bit more natural look, and so that's why I wear these guys. Thanks Fran, I appreciate that. Hang on, I don't have my lipstick here in my bag, so I'm gonna grab my purse real quick. And I'm back. All right. So, this is my bag from St. Martin. I think we were together when I bought this, Betty. When we were all in those little shops. Look at all the, this thing weighs about 2 pounds. I've got like so many lip colors and enduring lip colors and lipsticks and everything. Limelight just came out with some beautiful new lipsticks in a tube. When we first came out, we had lipsticks in a pan, because that's what makeup artists use. And so they came out first in the pan. Oops, I thought I had one right here to show you, but I don't. Anyway, and as our CEO Michelle said, that they chose that because The first thing that a makeup artist will do is take a tube lipstick and cut it up and put it into a pan so that it's easy for them to use when they're doing their job. And so that's what they use. But a lot of everyday ladies like to have a tube. It's a little bit easier to just grab a tube and open it up and slip it on. So let's see, what colors do I want? I have, these are our new tubes. Ooh, and it's hard to see because they're so reflective, but there's a beautiful L here. Oh yeah, remember when we were walking around St. Martin in those little shops? Oh, so beautiful. This one is 102. This is a beautiful pink. This one is called Ladies Night Pout. Again, with the puns. They're so cute. This is number 200. 200 is Femme Fire. And this is one of our sheers. We have five that are power pouts, which means they're full coverage. And then we have three that are sheer colors, and they're called Take a Hint. Like, they're just a hint of color. But the beautiful thing with our Take a Hints is that they are buildable colors. So you can do one stroke and you have that beautiful color. You can do two strokes there or more and get different intensities of your color. So look at how pretty those are. Now it's kind of a warm sheer russet color. And I did that one, 201, what is 201? 201 I think is Prim and Proper. I think we'll do some Prim and Proper. Oh, you are so sweet. I miss you so much, Laverne. Okay. And these are buttery soft, super, super smooth and creamy. Your lips will feel instantly better. This is a great everyday color. It's just a hint of pink, but such a neutral color that I think it's gonna look really fabulous on everyone. But super, super, it feels luxurious on your lips, seriously. It feels like butter, so creamy. I don't know if you can see the beautiful scoring diamond pattern on our tubes. Oh, they're just classy, clean. I mean, I say when you think of Limelight, think of Audrey Hepburn. That's what our line is. We are classy, professional. This is professional makeup. It's not store brand. It's not like anything else that you've tried. We're really one of a kind. So, okay, so there's my face. Thanks. I hope everybody enjoyed that. Oh, yes, I would love, Ogliver's on Voyager. Where is Voyager? Is it in Asia? Deb, how are you, girl? Nice to see you. I'm almost done. I've done my face, my lashes, my brows. I did my lazy girl brow. Thank you, Ginger. Yours is a gorgeous face too. Oh, it's been wonderful hanging out. I just feel like I've just been having a party with my friends. Okay, so just if anybody wants to see that, this is my hair that I have to deal with. I colored it last night, so you kind of see a shadow of that. But I'm gonna show you what I do. Oh, thank you. No, don't be sorry you're late. Oh, yeah, I know, we haven't sailed Asia. It's just, Michael doesn't, hi Elizabeth, nice to see you this morning. Laverne, we just don't have the time. Michael doesn't have the vacation. He hasn't had the vacation time built up to get to Asia. So they need to bring Voyager closer so that we can do something together. That would be awesome. Yeah, we're doing, I forgot to tell you guys where we're going. We're going at the end. We're sailing on the 30th with Betty and a bunch of other friends. Oh, this is just water. I'm spritzing on my hair. Because I'm going to cover my scalp here with my products that I use. Where is it? Did I leave it? No. Uh-oh. I think I have to run to go get it. I can't believe I lost it. I had it already, so I didn't have to open it. Hang on, I'll be right back. Promise. Move. Move. I can't believe it. I thought I was all ready. Sorry. Okay. That was really fun watching me run. Yes, please fly to me. You see my doggy? That's Indigo. Indy, say hi. Come here. Come here. Oh, puppy bear. Come on. Can you see? Get up here. He's our rescue. He is cattle dog and we don't know what else. Come on. Oh. Say hi. He's already beautiful. He doesn't have to put makeup on. Okay, he's got one blue eye. That's why he's Indigo. Okay. Oh, we leave in 30 more sleeps. Yes. I cannot wait. It's going to be so much fun. We love cruising. Unpack. Enjoy the rest of the trip. Oh, yeah, you wake up at a different port and get to go explore something else. And for any of my airline people that are on, we're going to go see the Spruce Goose. I am so excited. Okay. He says, hey, Fran. Okay. So this is, see, is it? It is in reverse. That's so weird. Why isn't it? You know, right. This is Couvray. It's made by a company called Spencer Forest, and it's an Opecia covering cream. Laverne, yes, we are Diamond Plus. And so is Betty and her husband Abe. So yeah, we enjoy our Diamond Club. Kind of bummed that they took the awesome concierge lounge out of Oasis and Allure, which was kind of a ripoff, if you ask me. It was so nice. We did get to enjoy it a couple of times, so we'll take it, but we still have fun in the Diamond Club. And they've done a different thing too. They've added three drinks to your card, your C Pass, to be used at most of the bars, and you can get three drinks at the other bars, so you don't actually have to be in the Diamond Club to get your drinks. And then you can go back to the Diamond Club and get a few more if you want. But it's kind of nice because we have some friends traveling with us that aren't elite status, so then we can go to a club or bar and have a couple of drinks with them as well. So it has its perks, but also some things that they took away. Okay, so I like to do this when my hair's a little bit damp and it keeps drying out. So I just squeezed out some of this, and it was a brand new tube, so it had a little bit of liquid in it. So I just kind of pull my hair up and I just kind of work this in so it starts to cover my scalp so you don't see the baldness come through. And I do have a couple of wigs, but I'm just not super confident wearing them. And I keep saying I'm going to go have them styled again and see if I can start wearing them. The other thing is that they are so hot. What? No, why did they do that? I don't know. I'm not in with the CEO of Royal Caribbean, so. Oh, yeah, we do still get our free pictures, and we always get our pictures, that's for sure. But nobody is as good at taking photos as you are. So we really miss that. So you can see how that just helps to cover. So then when I go to style my hair, you don't see all that scalp and you don't notice how bald I am. And I actually went to the hairstylist about 2 or 3 weeks ago and said, you know, I want to change because nothing looks you know, my hair doesn't stay curled, it doesn't do this, so what can we do? And she's like, really nothing more than what you're doing. So I was like, okay. So I ended up with the same hairstyle, so I might need to get a second opinion with that. Oh, really, Kim? Well, maybe I should make a trip down to see you, and then I can bring my wigs, and maybe she can help me with those, and maybe I need to get a different one. But I spent a lot of money on these wigs, and I just not really, you know, I just, it's not me when I look in the mirror. It just, and I guess it's just something that I'm going to have to get used to. Good morning, Julie. I've just been sitting here with some friends from all over the world, actually. Actually, I've got a few different countries. I've got Canada on here. I've got South Africa on here. And then all over the country. I hope it's being a good day in Phoenix for you guys. But right now I'm just showing what I do to cover up my baldness and my hair, so it's not so noticeable. It's something that, you know, when you people look at other women and compare, and which is, I don't recommend, because we were all given what we were given and we need to embrace that, but I look at people with good hair all the time and I think, oh my gosh, I just wish I had their hair. I wish I had half of their hair. But this is what I got, so I'm working with it. And if there's anybody out there that has, you know, that this helps you, go for it, you know. They have this alopecia coverage cream in lots of different colors, so anyway, and then so I put that on first, and then I'll dry my hair. Oops, I see a spot here. Oh, cool, Kim. Deb, I put this on every time when I wash my hair, and so I usually only wash my hair a couple of times a week. Yeah, it does cover really well. And, you know, once I get my hair styled and stuff, it definitely stays in. And then I also use this. It's called Topic. And there are little keratin fibers. So I'll spritz this in as well. And it will cover as well. And these two products combined really absorb. Well, you can see how it covers this area that I missed. And it clings to the hair that you have. So it actually makes your hair look a little bit fuller and thicker. Let me just pat that in. And as you know, after several days, tomorrow, go to couvre.com. It's C-O-U-V as in Victor, R-E.com. And it's made by Spencer Forrest. And these two products are what I use. So one is the Topics keratin fibers, and this one is the alopecia covering cream, concealing cream. And, you know, I've had them for, I buy them a lot. And they have like a, kind of like an auto ship program. Like, so what I'll do is I'll stock up. I'll order like a giant bottle of the fibers. And the atomizer tops are like extra. And I have a shorter bottle that I keep in my travel bag and an atomizer top. And then I buy the giant refills. And so I'll buy like a refill and two of the tubes. And I'll put it like on auto ship for a few months because then you get free shipping. And then I stock up on it and then I cancel my auto ship. And then I wait until I get low and then I'll do that again. So that's how I save a little bit of money on the shipping and stuff. And that way I've got always got you know, some backup. But so the color stays in until I wash it out. And yeah, it does work really well. Yeah, I hope it helps for your son tomorrow. You know, a lot of people don't know that there are some aids out there to help. And like my mom had has psoriasis, and she had it on her scalp from the time she was a young child, and it was that plaque psoriasis. And I can remember her, you know, pulling off sections, you know, just this plaque psoriasis that would build up, and over the years it would create scar tissue. So she's not even eligible for a hair transplant. And so something that's on my vision board that I'm working towards is a hair transplant. And I actually, what I need to do is actually send in some samples of my hair to see if I would be a candidate, because there's that company called Bosley, and it's kind of like, you've seen the commercials for the club for men's hair, or men's club for hair, or something like that. It's the same type of thing. It's where they actually take a strip of your scalp out, and then they stitch that up, and then they actually take each yeah, the stuff is crazy good. They actually cut each follicle out, and then they, with a scalpel, they tap in and implant all of those hair follicles, and over the crown of your head where you are missing hair. But you have to have, this has to be viable, you know, you have to have, you know, good blood flow, where my mom didn't. She doesn't have the blood flow there because of the scar tissue. And my husband always thinks it's hereditary, but there were several things that are contributing factors. There was a certain point in my life, about when I started losing a lot of the hair, where I'd had about 6 or 7 surgeries. And so the anesthesia and all of that. And then it was discovered that I had allergies, seasonal allergies. So they put me on Claritin and steroids can be a contributing factor. And so there were so many different variables that they really couldn't pinpoint what it was that was causing my hair loss. And it's just one of those things. It's, you know, people think that it's a vanity thing, and it's not. It's just, you want to feel normal. You want to feel like, you know, part of the rest of the world. And it's more common for men to have the baldness, but women can have that male pattern baldness as well. And it's just something that happens. But it's not as easily, you know, women have the choice of putting a wig on or just living with it. And so a lot of people that, you know, I see them with the baldness, and it's like, I want to take them aside and go, you know, there are some products that can help you, you know, if you want to feel a little bit better about how your hairline looks. So anyway. Oh, you know, and I thought about getting the hair care from Todd as well, with the Palmifera oil in it. Hey Sandy, good morning. I'm just about done here, but I'm glad you popped on. I just did my makeup for these ladies, and they picked my colors. So, but this is my normal go-to. This is what I do pretty much 90% of the time, is the gray shades. I really like those colors on my eyes. And, oh good. You'll have to tell me how it is. I mean, your hair is gorgeous and thick, so I'm sure it's going to be wonderful. But yeah, I would like to try it, and who knows? Our One Drop Wonder is so fabulous, so maybe it will do something for my scalp and get my hair follicles back working. So we'll see. But oh, I just don't want to say goodbye, because it's been so much fun hanging out with you guys, but I'm sure everybody else has got stuff to do, and I've got stuff to do. It's my husband's day off, and I know he wants to go do some running around and grab some food. And anyway, I will pop back on here in another, I don't know, day or so, or whenever I feel like I'm missing everybody. This has been such a great day. Any other questions that I could answer? Oh, and Laverne, message me and let me know what you want to do, and we can work out getting something shipped to you, okay? Thank you, Kim. You have a great day, too. Love you guys. Thanks, Sandy. You always look fabulous, my dear. No, don't go. Thank you, Fran. All right, you have a great day. Have a great day, everyone. This has been so much fun for me. I hope you enjoyed it. Hey, if you guys think of things you want me to do, either send me a message or, you know, pop on Facebook and say, hey, Karen, do a live and do this, something that you want to see, okay? And if I don't know, I'll be figuring it out and we'll learn it together. Okay, bye, Betty. Love you. We will see you soon. All right. All right, guys. Have a great day. Love y'all.